If two signal I have taken F1 two and F2, okay, the signal, the F1 signal can be approximate in terms of F2. We have given like this C1 to F2 T. Okay. If there is approximation sign, then we have to given like this. Okay. This is the symbol of approximation. So then what we are I'm going to write that error. What will be the error then? Error function or signal, you can write error function. Yeah, FAT is given by FAT equal to F1T minus, when you minus the this from F1 to minus F1 signal minus this approximation signal, then we will find the error. Okay, the error function of FE is given by F1T minus this C1 to this. Okay. Somebody misses. Did not note it, sir. You just write in the signal. I am start signals. No, you write there. Then let us consider two signal F1T and F2T. Okay. You just write that. Let us consider two signal F1T and F2T. Then you write the signal F1T can be approximate in terms of F2 over interval T greater than T1 less than T2. Just you write those. Then you write this equation. What I am saying, let us consider two signal F12 and F2T. Then the signal F1T can be approximate in terms of F2T over a certain interval T greater than T1 less than T2. Okay. The approximation is F1T is this. Okay. Then error will be how much? Error will be when I subtract these two terms, the error will become. And what I am saying that error should be minimum one, as I have said in the vector also, the BE term should be minimum. Okay, that's why we have to find error of the signal is calculated by mean square error. You can take in this case. Let us take the error. How we can calculate the error with the mean square error? Okay, we can take the we can find the mean square error. Okay, over the interval that is T1 to T2. Let us consider mean square error in the interval. Mean square error, you can write that symbol. Okay. In the interval. Interval. T1. T2, and it is given by epsilon 1 by T2 minus T1, T1 to T2, FE square T2. Okay, since mean means if something we divide with a whole number, the duration. Okay, since we are dividing with T2 minus T1 duration or time, then that is mean, and square means we are squaring the error. That's why it's named as mean square error. Okay, so we should write T2 minus T1 integration T1 to T2. We have to write this term F1T from here also we are going to find this C12. We are our aim of the derivation is to find the C12, and this C12 should be minimum one. Okay, that's why we are taking a minimum square error like this. This then we have to put this Fe from this equation Fe 12 cos 2 C12 F2 t whole square tt. Okay. Have you taken the note? What we are going to find? We are going to find the C12. Our target is to find that coefficient C12. Okay. How we can find? We know that the C12 is the minimum one. Okay. Minimum error. Minimum error. In this case, we have taken the mean square error. Okay. To calculate the mean square error, we just take this formula 1 by t2 minus t1 integration t1 to t2. Fe square t dt. Then we have put this Fe here. Let's go for the next slide. It's over, I think. So we are to find the epsilon, okay? But that epsilon has many value. But we need the minimum error. How we can find a minimum error? To find the value of C12, which keeps or which makes, okay, or which gives or which minimizes, which minimizes epsilon, okay. Then it should satisfy the condition. What is dou or d epsilon by dou C12 equal to 0? Understood? So we calculate, we are given a equation that is this epsilon equal to 1 by t. For suppose something, a function is given epsilon 1 by t2 minus t1 integration t1 to t2. Okay. Fe t minus f1 t minus c12 f2 t whole square dt. Okay. This is a function is given, okay. In this function will be minimum when, okay, or you can say that this function will minimum for this C12 value when d by epsilon by d C12 would be 0. We know something function is given like this, okay. Some function is given. Suppose this is ft, okay. So if we want to find the maximum point or the minimum point, what we should do? We should differentiate this function with with t, and we should equate the 0. If we differentiate, differentiation gives the maximum or minimum value. That you should know. That's why what we to find the value for this, of C12 for which that this function will be minimum. And it should be satisfied the condition what d epsilon by d C12 equal to 0. So just put like that, put the epsilon here C12 put epsilon t2 minus t1 to t2 F1 t minus C12 F2 t whole square dt equal to 0. Break the whole part dC12 t2 minus t1 then make a bracket. T1 to T2, then you break the whole part. F1 square T minus twice. If you take the integration to whole part, this is the formula. Twice T1 to T2, F1 T, C1 to F2 T, DT plus C1 square integration C1 to the T1 to T2, F2 T square DT. Okay. This should be equal to 0. So from here you can say where there will be no C1 term. In this term, there will be no C1 term, C1 to term. That's why it is when you differentiate with d by d C1 to, then this term will be become 0. But in this case, we have C1 term, and in this case also, we have C1 term. So please differentiate. 1 by T2 minus T1, what will have? This term will be 0. How this time? This d by C12 will be 1. That's why it's come as a T1 by T2 by F1 T, F2 T, DT. Then is square is d by C12. C12 square means twice C12. So it will come twice C12 T1 T2 F2 square DT. Okay, this 1 by T2 minus T1 will be 0, will become 0 when you take in the right hand side. Then what are the two terms we have? It's over. What are the two terms we have? We have this minus twice T1, T2, F1, T, F2, T, DT, plus YC1, T, T1, T2, F2, square, T, DT, equal to 0. From here, if you taken this part, if you taken this part at the right side, then we have C12 equal to 2 to cancel, we'll have T1, T2, F1, T, F2, T, DT by T1, T2, F2, T square, DT. This is the ultimate formula that we are trying to find. The coefficient of approximation in terms of signal. Somebody says previous test. Please write soon. Class here, please take the attendance at this end of the class.
Yes, sir.
Please do it fast.
Yes, sir. Taken, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh.
Yes.
This is how we have find the coefficient of approximation for the signal. Okay, so what we find for the vector, can you say we get the C12 in terms of vector would be what? V1 dot V2 by V2
by
So, so if you compare this B1 vector as F1 signal and B2 vector as F2 signal, then we can say that dot product is nothing but here integration, okay? And understood? And this is F2 signal. You can relate like that. Then dot product comes as an integration in case of signal, or other thing you can say. If vector b1 dot b2 equal to 0 means perpendicular, okay? And integration c1 to c2, f1 to f2 t, dt equal to 0 means they are orthogonal. One thing I have to give as a note. Okay, take as a note. I'll take a 5 minutes more. Is okay? Or tomorrow I'll give that note. Let me give the note. Only 2 points I'll give. That's important. That will be complete this topic. Notice that what we have find C12 equal to B1 dot B2 by B2 in case of vector, okay? If B1 and B2 are perpendicular, then what will happen? The dot will be 0. If dot here 0, then C12 will be 0. Understood? C12 0 means the vector B1 has no component or cannot represent, okay? Has no component. Along the other vectors B2. There has no component, okay? Or we cannot represent P1 in terms of B2. If C12 equal to 0. If they are perpendicular, the C12 will be 0, okay? And two vectors, you can write, and two vectors, B1 and B2 are visually perpendicular. Understood? Visually perpendicular means they are independent, okay? So the question may be asked, what is orthogonality for the vectors? Then you have to write this definition. Definition is orthogonality. Let me write orthogonality of vectors. Then you can write. What? The vector which are mutually perpendicular to each other are called orthogonal vectors. What is called orthogonal vectors? They may ask. The vectors which are perpendicular to each other are called orthogonal vectors. And you can write after that, then orthogonal vectors are independent. Okay. So this is a note from the vectors, and a similar note can be given from the signal. Is it over?
Yes, sir.
Similar note can be given from the signal. Let me complete this topic. Only 2 minutes more. From signal note 2. Two signal F1T and F2T are orthogonal if the integration or if the integral of the product of those signals is zero. That is T1, T2, F1T, F2T, TT should be zero. Okay? Orthogonality. What do you mean by orthogonality? In case of signal, orthogonality implies that a function or a signal, a function does not contain any component of the form of the other function. So this analogy part I have completed. A few more notes there I will give next class, but you should go through the notes. Okay, of what I have taught today, please go through with the notes, and if you have any doubt, okay, let me know. I will try to clear your doubt in the next class. And I, if required, I will explain once again. Please try to find the valid questions. Okay, you go through the note. If you don't understand, then let me know.